There's plenty of work all the year round on an Australian sheep station. But in the shearing season, the tempo quickens. Shearing is the event of the year. The sheep are drafted into the yards. The lambs separated from the ewes. And then, generally the day before shearing is due to commence, the shearers arrive. They work as a team. And because it's always the shearing season in some part of Australia's vast sheep country, they're always on the move. Boss of the board is Joe, who runs the outfit. And here's the cook, wife of one of the boys. Steve is an old-timer known in every shed in the country. With him comes Don, who's doing his first season as a fully-fledged shearer. In Steve's early days, he slept on bags of straw in slab huts. Now his old bones appreciate the comforts provided in these more enlightened days. Purse is spokesman for the men and a representative of the Australian Workers' Union, which looks after their interests. His first job at any new shed is to run a ballot for positions on the shearing board. Settling down means doing all the chores that face men who have to look after themselves. Old Steve has a hobby that helps him pass an idle hour when he has one. In the shed, last-minute preparations are in full swing. Speed means money when you're paid by results, and everything must be ready for them to start in the morning. Ready for the first run, each man brings his own jewelry, combs and cutters for the handpiece. The rest of the machinery belongs to the owner of the shed. They wear flat shirts to absorb the sweat, and special boots without nails, because soon the board will be greasy, and a slip with a racing handpiece could mean a wicked gash. Some of the boys make their own moccasins, as they call them, out of stacking. And Steve are both out to be ringer of the shed, the man with the best daily tally. The wool rollers can take it easy for a little longer as they wait for their first fleece. In this game, more haste means less speed and damaged sheep as well. It looks effortless, but after a day of bent backs and concentration on the clean, long swing of that strong right arm, they're mighty glad to fall into bed. It's Purse who gets the first wool away, but that's only one sheep of the many that he and Steve will shear today. The boys and rollers can't smoke now. If the board isn't kept clear, there'll be roars from the shearers. So the fleece has come over the rolling tables at a rate that keeps the rollers hard at work tearing off the dirty edges. The aristocrat of the shearing shed is the wool classer, a highly paid expert who sorts for length of staple, texture and strength. He's a key man in maintaining the world reputation of fine Australian wool. The presser has one of the toughest jobs in the shed. He gets paid according to the weight of wool he presses. over it comes. Now he has to squeeze the contents of the top and bottom boxes together into the bale. And there it is. 350 pounds of the world's best wool. In the kitchen, the cook is hard at work, too. This isn't a meal, just a light snack for morning smoker. Each man pays so much ahead for his rations, and there's trouble for any cook, male or female, if they don't get the best. Young Peter the Rouseabout is getting a chance to learn on a partly finished sheep that one of the shearers had handed over when the smoker bell was due. Peter's ambition is to get a learner's pen next year, and then he'll be in the big money the year after. Each man cleans his handpiece and jewelry, then leaves it to be sharpened by the machinery expert. In this case, the boss of the board. Of the day comes after two tough hours, and they're ready for food as well as rest. But the boss of the board is still on the job, counting out the pens and entering each man's tally against his name. It looks as though Perce will be the ringer. The talk is about the job, of course. Other sheds and other days. Good bosses and bad sheep. Of ringers and gun shearers like Jackie Howe, with his unbroken record of 321 sheep in a day, made with the hand blades in the days before machinery. Perce rolls a few smokes to save time later on, while Steve has a look at what's coming up. Wrinkled or dirty sheep, hard to shear, he'll leave until nearly knock-off time. That sort are known as cobblers, because they stick to the last. It's a long day, and as it wears away, old Steve shows all the confident economy of movement that made him a gun shearer in his day. Off comes the belly wool, which goes into a separate bin. Then the left flank. It's ticklish work around the neck, where the racing cutter buried deep under the wool could easily cut the sheep's throat. Then over she goes onto her side for the long blow from the flank to the top of the head. A few short blows on the side and it's over. Down the chute goes the sheep, and Steve has another almost before the boy can whisk the fleece away. And so it goes for the men who gather Australia's golden fleece. There's one load for the railhead. And in a week or two, when the shed's cut out, the shearers will be on their way too. For once you're in the game, you feel lost if you're not on the move. Following the season with always a new shed to go to, new country to see. On this sheep station, the shearing season is over. But for Bill and boys like Don, gun shearers like Perce, and old-timers like Steve, the season never ends.